Hi, it's me. I'm coming from my home studio for the Greek Hour. When I was a little girl in Baltimore, we had this show on every Sunday on the radio called the Greek Hour, and this is my version. I wish I could speak with you in person, but because I can't, I thought I'd create a little diversion and talk about a subject that is very serious, and that is finger cymbals and jazz. Yeah. Don't turn off your computer yet. Stick with me, stick with me. You might really love finger cymbals and not really be in tune with jazz, or vice versa. You love jazz and you don't know what finger cymbals have to do with them at all. But just hang in there with me for a moment. When I started my idea about singing jazz, I came out of, a Middle Eastern cultural tradition of dance and music, starting from a little kid as a folk dancer, and dancing to Greek music, evolving into Arabic. And then I became very, very interested in jazz. I love the ballad element of jazz, but mostly I was really interested in the rhythms. And you might think, like, what's the connection between those two worlds? Well, when I was dancing, there was always a big Arabic band behind me, live band, live music, and they'd perform music to a theme. And that theme would complete itself, the form, one time through, and then they would all go off and improvise on the various instruments. And it was absolutely fantastic. And the dancer really had to listen to the improvisational element and to the rhythm to stay connected to the music. And of course, there were slow romantic pieces as well, but the up-tempo ones were the ones that really, really fascinated me the most. So then, when I started singing later on in life, I was very attracted to the world music element of jazz, the things that Dizzy Gillespie put forth, in Night in Tunisia, and Duke Ellington in Caravan, Juan Tiesel's composition. So that's how I really got those two worlds connected, and I thought about creating a band, and that's why I named it Black Olive Jazz. And there's a whole history to that name, but I won't go into that now, just to say that it was given to me by an actor, Stephen Anthony Jones. That's another story. But the way that I express myself, maybe differently than other performers in jazz, is that I use the element of finger cymbals. I don't use them in swing. I love swing. But when I have an exciting beat that I want to create a groove to, I use finger cymbals. And here's a pair right here. They're pretty amazing. Yeah. They were given to me by Suhaila Salimpour, who is a phenomenal performer. She is also a fantastic teacher, and she has a whole line of finger cymbals. And her mother, Jamila Salimpour, wrote this amazing book called An Illustrated Manual of Finger Cymbals. It is an incredible, incredible book. It has gorgeous historical illustrations. Here's one that I love a lot. This is a dancer playing, snapping her fingers in an Arabic kind of style. That's from the Chicago World's Fair, in fact. And the snap is like this. Not like this. Yeah, it's a really cool snapping thing. The next illustration that I love, these are a couple of, depictions of ancient Greece and the dancer with finger cymbals there. Here, the percussive instruments on her fingers, and this one I love as well. This one is a Coptic priest with cymbals. Amazing, huh? That religious element of it. But and the way that Jamila wrote everything out was really incredible. See, she would break it down into beats, naming each of the beats as she broke them down. So just absolutely amazing depiction of finger symbols. Some jazz musicians really dig when I play them. Mostly they do. Like most of the drummers I work with really think they're cool. They embrace them. I've met a few people that are very skeptical. I worked with a piano player one time that actually told me to stop playing. It was my gig. And this person said, stop your cymbals. And needless to say, we never worked together again. That's life. But to each their own. But most of the time, people really do dig them. And I'm going to do some examples of music that I created utilizing these Middle Eastern grooves and different finger cymbals. So first set of finger cymbals are these huge set. These are made out of metal. They are not, finger cymbals are not made out of wood. Those are castanets. Valeriana Quevedo is fantastic at castanets, and she and I do duos all the time with finger cymbals and castanets. Let's see if I can get these on. They're a little bit difficult to get on. Once they're on, they're cool. So these are the Jamila size. They're really big and they got a real loud sound, so look out, but they're really cool. So I'll do a little six groove with them. Pretty neat, huh? They're so big. And I would never use those performing with a band unless I was with like a huge band, that I wouldn't overpower with that sound. So the next size down, these are called the Suhela size finger cymbals, and they're really, really neat. They're a little lighter sound. They still make a lot of noise. And I'm gonna play a different groove on these. So I just did a 6/8 on that one. Now this, I'm gonna do a beat called a shiftatelli, which is, there are 8 beats with an emphasis on the 1, 5, 6, and 7. So it's so I use them a lot. I use them in one of the songs that I'm gonna play for you later, Temptation. Shiftatelli, it's usually done during taksim. Taksim is the slow part of the song where the musicians improvise. And that's a little taksim groove there. The next symbol that I have here are, these are the size I usually use on recordings. And by the way, on recordings, it comes out so much better than it does here in my parlor. I do the best I can with what I got here, but just bear with me while I put these on. These are a little tight, this pair. So these are called the Isabella line. Isabella is Suhela's daughter, who is a wonderful singer as well as a fantastic dancer. And I think she uses finger cymbals in her music as well. She's brought them in. So I'm gonna do a little different beat with this. This is a belody. Belody goes. These are very, very lightweight. I got them online. I do not know the manufacturer, but they won't be quite as loud as the others. They are not as good a quality, but they're good to illustrate maybe a little lighter groove. So the 9/8 is called Kashlama. Kashlama. So I've got a recording coming out soon with Aaron Germain and with Dave Rokeach and Noel, where we're going to use a 9/8 to footprints, but this is how a 9/8 would be in Middle Eastern music. So you can see these are like super lightweight. I had a really beautiful pair that were stolen, and they had this gorgeous roll to them. I could really get a roll in them, but not so much, with these. So I want to play a few selections just so you can hear how these different modes that I chose sound on recordings that I made. And as always, Noel really helps me so much in this world because he can, do these incredible arrangements. So the first one I want to play is The Night in Tunisia. Night in Tunisia, Noel did this arrangement with a Ray Brown groove, Ray Brown, the bass player. And when he brought it to me, I was like, how perfect. A 6/8, just up my alley. So I'll play a little bit of that for you. And that's me on finger cymbal 6/8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's Dave Rokeach and Noel, of course. Carla Kaufman on bass, putting down that groove.
The moon is the same moon above you, a glow in the
Okay, I'm going to stop it there because, you can always buy the album. Oh my God, wouldn't that be amazing? So the next one I want to introduce you to is Caravan. So I got this idea by listening to McCoy Tyner's version, which is in an Afro-Cuban 6, and then it goes into swing. And this is McCoy Tyner. It's just so beautiful. Hear that 6? 1, 4, 6. He goes into that swing there. Now back. Isn't that gorgeous? It's so Moroccan, Belly dancers know what I'm talking about. Good. So I loved that so much that I wanted to create my own version. So I recorded Caravan with Larry Vukovich and Bill Douglas set down this groove. I wanted to do a senior blues feel underneath of it. And then on drums, Eddie Marshall, who really loved my finger cymbals too. I'm very grateful for that. So here they are. Let's see my version of Caravan. Comes Bill. There's Larry with that bumpkin chords. And there's my little attempt at, improvisation there. Okay, so next, Temptation was something that I recorded very recently with Noel Juke Septet. And that one I'm using a little bit of Belody in. You can hear that. So those last couple were 6s. This is the Belody. Let me see if I can play along to this without, drowning it out on the camera. So let's see, what did I say? Temptation. Doom doom tech tech doom tech tech doom doom tech tech doom tech tech doom doom tech tech doom tech tech. And there's Noel, come on. I was alone. Yeah, I'm still alone. I mean, who knew when I recorded that? We'd all be alone. All right. Next one, and we're almost done, if I still have you with me. I hope I do. Cleopatra and the Viper. Noel wrote this incredibly beautiful song, and he wrote it about the Viper and Dick Tracy, but I thought it was about Cleopatra and the Viper. So I composed the lyrics, but for now, let's talk about and listen to this groove. Noel, of course, lays down this beautiful soprano sax thing, and I'm doing finger cymbals under it. Tick-a-tack, doom, tick-a-tack.
The Queen of the Nile died by a viper.
Okay, that's that. And so I'm going to leave you in a moment with a couple of other things. One more. Let's see if I have... Whatever Lola Wants. So Whatever Lola Wants, this is Bill Douglas on Arco. So pretty, such a beautiful introduction. And
Whatever Lola,
I do this little setup for it, and then it
Lola
comes in with finger cymbals very soon, I swear.
And little Lola wants you.
Let's just stop. Maybe I'll fast forward that one a little bit so you don't have to sit through that whole thing. Let's see if I got him there.
If you're through, I always get.
Actually, it comes in much later. The finger cymbals. Let's skip that one. But trust me, it's in there. Lola. So let me see if I can just illustrate what it would be like with Lola. Da da da. So, yeah, just me, Arco, bass, and some bongos. Actually, Isabel Douglas plays on the accordion later in that song. If you want to listen to it, it's all over the place. Whatever Lola Wants. So it would be
Whatever Lola Wants, Lola Gets, and Little Man. Little Lola wants you.
So that's how it would go if we wanted to struggle through that entire song. The other one that I play with a lot is Besame Mucho. It's a Latin feel. I did that with Almelina one time at Seven Mile House. Let's see if we can get this one. This version is just, the instrumental, so I didn't put the cymbals on it. See if I can play along with it. That's Lenny Carlson on guitar. Another project I'm working on with Aaron Germain and Deborah Keach. We're doing a 9/8 to Footprints, Wayne Shorter's tune. Yikes, it's really fast, but I think it'll be cool. I think it's going to work out okay. Thank you so much for hanging in here with me. I love you. I do this live, but I'm kind of a Facebook idiot when it comes to that thing. So thanks for listening to this recording. Stay safe. Love each other. Let's eliminate all these unnecessary explosions. Let's go for quiet, beautiful music. Lots of love. Bye-bye.